This video is going to be a guide of how to play Skyblock on Roblox. So, there are a lot of things that people are confused about in the game, so I'm just making this video. Hopefully, I'll explain everything that you're confused about. So, even if you already know most things about everything, I'm gonna try to explain it as well as I can, so you might find how to do something better or something. But anyways, so once you first play the game, then you have to just mine some of your grass and make a bridge to the main area over there. Then you should just farm, which is kind of easy to do, but I'll just be showing all of the things that can be kind of confusing that most people don't really know how to do. By the way, I'm still on my alt right now. I've been building on my island. But make sure to subscribe with notifications on if you want more help on Roblox Skyblock. And if you have Discord, join the Discord server in the description. Like the video, because these are going to be some pretty good tips. But anyways, yeah, my island's pretty big now. I have a big farming area there, and I just have a whole bunch of areas that keep going up. But anyways, I'm also trying to trade my stuff and sell things and buy things with coins. So I'm farming a lot. I'll probably have at least 10,000 more coins by the time this video is uploaded. So let me know any offers you have for anything or anything that you would sell for coins in the comments. And also, you can join me, and you guys can also just trade in the comments, like, write your offers in the comments, and other people can look at them and just trade you. But, yeah, so, first thing that I'm gonna show is rotating things, which I showed in my last video, but they changed it. I swear they changed it. They changed it and did a little bit of things to it whenever you try to place something. So, let me just get my anvil to show you guys. Okay, so now it's, most of the time it's where your camera is facing, but sometimes your character has to be facing that way too. I don't know why it's like that now, but like half of the time when you're trying to place something, it doesn't let you place it there unless if your character is facing there also. But anyways, next thing I'm gonna show is, or well, I'm just gonna tell you that you don't have to have blocks connecting, and you can make it separate. Like, there's no gravity at all in this game except for your character, which some people were asking about that. And I thought since they already had another island, then that would be clear that it is not like that. But, well, yeah, you don't have to place anything how it has to be. You can just place something and then mine the block in between it, and it can be standing up by itself. Okay, now I'm gonna show how to drop items and how to trade. So, there are very many different ways that you can trade. So, how you drop items, first of all, you equip it in your inventory, you take it out, and then you press Q. Every time that you press Q, it will drop one. I'm not completely sure about mobile, but there's probably something you click on mobile, or I'm not completely sure, but people on mobile do drop things, but on PC, I'm pretty sure, on PC, you just press Q to drop it. I almost said it. I'm pretty sure you press Q, but I just did. But anyways, so how you trade, there are three types of ways to trade, or actually two types of ways. Or actually, nah, never mind, three. Okay, so the first way is probably the worst, because people end up getting scammed a lot. Like, it's just where two people stand by each other, and then one person is like, hey, this for this, drop the thing. And then, like, half of the time, both people drop the thing and it's good. The other half of the time, one person just steals everything, and then the other person has been scammed. So I recommend don't do that. The best way to do this is, so you can either have trading boxes, which I didn't do that, or you can have trading areas, which is kind of what I did. So I have two possible trading areas. This is the first one, and it Yeah, so how it will work is one person drops their stuff and the other person drops their stuff, and then we both stand to the side so that we can see the other person's stuff and make sure everything is there. And then once we both agree, then we both start running. So it's long enough that we have enough time, like if I'm here and then I see they're starting to take their stuff, then I just go back and take my stuff and no one will be able to steal anything. But the even better way is the stairs. So someone could drop their stuff on that side, I could drop my stuff on this side, and then once we're at the top of the stairs, we can look under, and if the person still has it there, then we run to the other side and get it. So yeah, trading is kind of complicated if you don't want to get scammed, but yeah, I have some good trading ways. But by the way, I have 7 onion totems. I don't know how I really got them. There's this guy that was just selling them, and so I converted a lot of my coins to coin bags, and I just traded them with him. But we use the thing at my base, this thing right here. If it's a lot of things, I guess it would be better to use something flat like this so that none of the items fall. But if it's just a few things that could fit right here without falling over, then this would be better. But yeah, probably the most effective, or actually, well, trading boxes would also be kind of effective. So how that would work would be, so one person, since it's their island, they have builds, the other person doesn't. So there would be 2 boxes. One that one person stands in, one that the other person stands in. They would be completely inside of the blocks, except just for one window, and then probably like 4 blocks worth of space in between, and then a window on the other person's box, so they can both see that there's what they want in there. Now, one person will still have to go kind of first, so the person with the builds would mine out of their box and make sure that everything is in the other person's box, and then once they do that, then you can mine the other person's box and they go out and you finish the trade. So yeah, that's why I didn't do that, since it can be kind of complicated. But the best thing that you can do is just this thing right here. So yeah, that's how to drop items and how to trade. And also, some people were wondering about how to get berries and berry bushes. You can't buy them. The only way you can get them is by getting another one from a seed, or trading for it, or getting one from a friend. Now, I farmed berries yesterday for the entire 17 hours I was on this game, and they weren't really that good. Like, I only got one berry bush while on my main account whenever I was farming them for the entire 14 hours I was on the game. I ended up getting like 10. So I don't know why my luck with the berry bushes is so low, but you can only get seeds by doing that, by trading or just randomly getting one from collecting the berries. You get berries from collecting them from berry bushes. But also, if you want to get a whole bunch of berry bushes fast, then you can. There's nothing in the game that says against making an alt account and giving yourself the stuff. Because you can just make an alt, and right when you join the game, then you'll have a starter base that has a berry bush. So you could instantly just make alts, and with about a minute, you could get a berry bush. So you could get a whole bunch of them quickly, because it only would take like a minute each, or if you could do it fast, like 30 seconds each. So that's way better than waiting like 10 hours to get lucky with one of the seeds you collect from it. So I don't know if they'll change that in the future where you can't make alts to do stuff. But right now, if you make an alt, then you can, well, the island is not really that useful. It would take a long time just to mine all of the stuff rather than just buying it. So yeah, the only thing kind of useful about making a new account is getting the berry bush, but that's it. So berries are the second top selling thing, so they're pretty good. Onions are the top, but they cost like 2,000 per seed, which is very expensive. I don't know if in a future update if they're gonna add berry seeds or something, but I don't really buy seeds, I just farm a whole bunch. Like, I bought one onion seed, and I farmed it to 4, which is good, because if I farm the rest of today, then I can farm it to 16, and then after that, I can farm it to, like, 64 the next day, and it will keep going up, and yeah. Also, I farmed just, like, 10 wheat to all of this, and I farmed just, like, 6 carrots to all of this, and I farmed 4 tomato plants to about 4 times the tomato plants also. By the way, carrots have a very, very high extra seed rate whenever collecting them. Onions have a low one, but since carrots have a super high one, I recommend to farm carrots because they're actually pretty good. So the best crop to farm would be wheat because it's the fastest to harvest because it's the biggest, so you can put your cursor on it and just spam F. Unlike onions, since they have a very small thing right there, it takes a little longer. But yeah, if you're new, farm wheat. If you're an older player, farm carrots. I recommend don't waste your time on other plants. I just have other plants because, well, I traded for it, so I'd rather use it than waste it. So yeah, I guess I am trading my tomato seeds also. And I'm not trading my onion seeds because I'm keeping my onions. Because, well, I have a whole bunch of onion totems. So I should put them to use unless if someone wants to trade for them. Which I guess I'd sell the onion totems for like 7k gold each because they were 8k. So that's a little bit off from the cost. So if someone wants to buy one, then I can give them a small deal on it. But I'm not gonna like sell it for... Some people literally buy it and then try to sell it for over the price at the store. The person that they're trying to sell it to can literally just go to the store and get it for less. So there are 3 more things that I'm going to show you guys. So how to get flowers, use totems, and get clay. So clay, the only way you can get it, you need 10,000 coins. You just go and get the clay totem, you place it, and then it will spawn clay. So yeah, it's pretty easy to do. You just have to have 10,000 coins to get it. The totem guy is if you go over here to the shop. But also, I'll tell you guys how to get flowers because it's very related. So the only way to get flowers, like actually get flowers, you have to buy the 200 Robux Game Pass or however much it is to get the floral bench. I recommend not to do that because that's very pay to win, and I don't think that they should make a decorations cost Robux. Like, it's something that is normally spawning in the game, so they just randomly spawn around your island also, so you can just get them very quickly. Like, one spawns every minute or so you can get flowers quickly and easily and stuff. But yeah, the clay totem's right there, and you go to the floral bench, and then you have to craft them with clay. But other than that, they literally just spawn around your base for free, and sometimes give you an extra seed with it. So yeah, just get flowers at your base. Don't waste your Robux on the bench. But now I showed how to get clay and the flowers. So how to use totems. So they updated it. So you can put food totems by things. I recommend to have it in the dirt over here. You still have to place the seed of whatever food it is by the totem, or else it won't do anything. But it will... Totems basically just collect the food that's already for whatever food it is, and then they keep it inside of the totem. But if you put it by a conveyor, then it will put it on the conveyor. So you can do that with just a conveyor, and it will go on the ground and you can pick it up. So it basically auto-farms food for you. Or you can put a chest at the end, an industrial chest, which you get by crafting a chest up from the anvil. But yeah, you just do something like what I have here. That's a conveyor, more conveyors, chest, and another chest. Wherever the arrows are pointing, that's where the conveyors are facing. You can do this exact same setup, but with food. And it would have to be in the dirt though, or whatever your farming area is that has dirt. But yeah, hopefully this video helped you all. Make sure to subscribe with notifications on because I'll make more videos on this game. Make sure to like the video because these were some pretty good tips. And if you have Discord, join the Discord server linked in the description. Last thing, shout out to all my channel members. If you want to see your name on this board, all you have to do is press the join button to the left of the subscribe button and then join the channel, and your name will be on this list next video, along with special stuff in live streams and video premieres like a chat tag, chat color, symbol by your name, and a whole bunch of other stuff in live streams and video premieres. So if you want to and you do, then thanks, but thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, YouTube.